our point of vantage at the top of the pass, we look down a gorge to a delightful valley, carpeted in various shades of green, brown, and yellow. But the eye does not linger over the picture far below. It is caught at once by the splendid sight opposite, a row of snow-clad giants stretching from north to south as far as the eye can reach, a serrated wall so high as I had never beheld, rising from 12,000 to 15,000 feet above the valley. Eagerly, I search out Waskadon at the south, a trifle higher than the rest. Magnificent Waskadon, towering far above the valley. I was filled with dismay at my own temerity in dreaming for a moment of its conquest.
Crammed in a small canvas tent at 18,000 feet, Annie Peck and five ill-clad Indian porters shiver away the night as avalanches rake the slopes above. During the day, the little party had fought valiantly to reach the saddle between the twin summits of Waskadon, but a treacherous labyrinth of crevasses combined with whiteout conditions stymied their progress far below their goal. Now, during the bitterly cold early morning hours, Annie struggles to make preparations for the day's climb. She wrestles with silk undergarments, sealskin trousers, and high-laced boots, attempts to coax a flame out of her kerosene stove, and prepares her scientific instruments that will validate, she hopes, the first ascent of the highest point in the Western Hemisphere, Waskadon.
During the night, I meditated upon the morrow. What should we do? A whole day would be required to reach the top of the saddle, another to attain the summit, at the least two more nights on the ice, with the probability of success small in view of what we had encountered already. I could endure the hardships well enough, but could the men?
As morning approaches, she turns to her huddled companions to encourage them to prepare, but they do not stir. Cold and fear have paralyzed them. With entreaties in Spanish, Annie offers double and then triple their wages, but the otherwise stalwart and faithful Quechua Indians are adamant. This is the lair of the gods, and if they climb any higher, they believe they will certainly turn to stone. Disconsolate, Annie boils water for her hypsometer to measure the altitude. As she prepares her tea, she slowly realizes that she must again return to Young Guy and the valley. Her second attempt of Waskadon has ended in failure.